Students, we will be discussing chemical kinetics chapter today. After electrochemistry, the chances of getting numerical problems is quite high from this chapter. Mostly very interesting, challenging, sometimes above average questions are picked from chemical kinetics. So students desirous of getting high ranking in CET should concentrate more on this chapter also, chemical kinetics. Apart from electrochemistry, chemical kinetics is the one way from which numerical problems, the two challenging problems, are picked. So a few formulae you are supposed to remember in this chapter. You must not waste time for formulae in the exam hall. We get two important formulae for a zero order reaction. K is equal to S R naught minus R divided by T2 minus T1 or T, time interval. For a first order reaction, K equals 2.303 by T log of R naught by R. This is for zero order reaction. This is for first order reaction. T half equals half life period R naught by 2k zero order and 0.693 by k first order. Then we have log of K2 by K1 equals EA by 2.303 R into T2 minus T1 by T1 T2 for the activation energy of a reaction. The unit of rate constant of a reaction is given by mole per liter to the power of 1 minus n per second. So these are some of the simple formulae you are supposed to remember in this chapter. So while working problems, we may need one or two more formulae which we can discuss in that context. But these are the main formulae that are being used in this chapter. In chemical kinetics, you should be very clear about the rate of a reaction, rate of formation of a product, rate of disappearance of a reactant. If a student is clear in these three terms, mostly mistakes are not done in this chapter. Students, we shall now discuss the questions one by one. Now I will be discussing question number one. Question number one, in the reaction Cl2 plus 2i minus gives I2 plus 2Cl minus. This is the reaction given. Observe the reaction first. The initial and final concentration of I minus are given to be 0.045 and 0.025, initial and final concentrations. You have been asked to find in the time interval 10 minutes the rate of formation of iodine, means di2 by dt. So be clear about what has been given and what are you supposed to find. Concentration of I minus changes from 0.0245 to 0.025 in 10 minutes. So rate of disappearance of I minus, what is this called? Rate of disappearance of I minus equals, take the difference between these two, 5 minus 5, 0, 2, 0, divided by the time interval. That should be 0.002. Okay, this is called rate of disappearance of I minus. I have been asked to find the rate of appearance of iodine. What you do is divide the rate of disappearance of I minus from its stoichiometric coefficient, then you will get rate of the reaction. Very important point to note, rate of disappearance of a reactant or rate of formation of a product, when divided by the respective stoichiometric coefficient, gives the rate of the reaction. Once you find the rate of the reaction, suppose you want rate of formation of iodine, if the stoichiometric coefficient is 1, rate of formation is same. If the stoichiometric coefficient is 2, multiplied by 2. Rate of formation of Cl minus will be 2 into this. Iodine will be 1 into this. So the answer rate of form, this is same as d of I2 divided by dt. So option A is correct. We shall go to problem number 2. Problem number 2, for a first order reaction, if log of reactant to the base E is plotted against time, time on x-axis, log of R on y-axis, the slope of the straight line obtained is, that means log R to the base E is plotted against time. Look, in a first order reaction, log of R is directly proportional to T. So you get a straight line. But what is the formula? K equals 2, or T equals 2.303 by K log of R naught by R, which can be written as log of R naught minus log of R. So T equals 2.T is directly proportional to log of R naught, whose coefficient is minus 1 by k. So the when you plot a graph of time against log R, you get a straight line whose slope is minus 1 by k. So option C is correct. Remember, when a graph of log of R to the base E is plotted against T, the slope is minus 1 by K. Suppose log R is plotted, it is 2.303 by K. Option C is correct. Question number 3. For a zero order reaction, T half and T 3 by 4. They are given. For a zero order reaction, T half and T 3 by 4 are time for half change and 3 fourths. What is the ratio of T half is to T 3 by 4? Options given are 1 is to 2, 2 is to 1, 2 is to 3, 3 is to 2. Simple. T half of a zero order reaction is given by 1 into R naught divided by 2 into K. Remember, for a zero order reaction, multiply the numerator by R naught, denominator by K, you get the formula. Same thing you apply for 3 by 4 also. Multiply the numerator by R naught, denominator by K. So, take the ratio. T 3 by 4 divided by T half, but you have been asked T half is to 3 T 3 by 4, means first T half R naught by 2K divided by 3 R naught by 4K. R naught gets cancelled. So 2 1s are, 2 2s are, it is 2 by 3. So the answer is 2 is to 3. Option C. Let me repeat again. For a zero order reaction, T half is R naught by 2K. T 3 by 4 is 3 R naught by 4K. Divide one by the other, you get the answer. Question number 4. In the reaction, A gives products. Follows first order kinetics. First you must observe the order of the reaction carefully. First order kinetics. From the following data, the rate constant would be, T is given. T is given as 100 seconds. Square bracket A is given, 0.9 mole per dm cube. When T is 200 seconds, a square bracket A is 0.09 mole per dm cube. So at two time intervals, you have been given the concentration and time. You have been asked to find the rate constant for a first order reaction. When the concentration of the reactant is given at two time intervals, we have a formula. You must note this formula. K by 2.303, K is equal to 2.303 by T2 minus T1 into log of R1 by R2. Let me repeat. K is equal to 2.303 by T2 minus T1 into log of R1 by R2. T2 is the final time. T1 is initial, R1 initial, R2 final. So 2.303 by T2 minus T1, 200 seconds minus 100 seconds into log of R1 means this, R2 is this. 0.09 cancel by 10 times, log 10 is 1. So the answer is 2.303 by 100 or 2.303 into 10 to the power of minus 2. So look at the option. Option A is the correct answer. So you must note down this formula. When two time intervals are given, K is given by, for a first order reaction, 2.303 by T2 minus T1 into log of R1 by R2. Substitute, you will get the answer. Question number 5. In a chemical reaction, the rate is doubled when the concentration of the reactant becomes 4 times. Suppose there is a reactant R. Rate is doubled when the concentration of the reactant becomes 4 times. Suppose R equals K into A to the power of n, say. The rate becomes 4 times when the concentration is doubled. 2 becomes 4 when the power is 2. So power itself is order. So therefore the order of the reaction should be 2. The rate becomes 4 times when the concentration is doubled. Doubled means it becomes 2 times. 2 can become 4 only when the power is 2. So the order of the reaction is 2. Option A is correct. Question number 6. The decomposition of N2O5 follows first order reaction. First write the equation, rate law equation. R equals K into square bracket N2O5 raised to the power of 1. How do you know that it is raised to the power of 1? Because in the problem we have given it as first order reaction. Rate equals 5 into 10 to the power of 6. Rate is given. 5 into 10 to the power of minus 6. mole per dm cube per second. At a concentration of N2O5 equals 1.25 into 10 to the power of minus 2 mole per liter, given in the problem. Rate is given, concentration is given. You have been asked to find rate constant 5 into 10 to the power of minus 6 upon 1.25 into 10 to the power of minus 2 means it is 4 into 10 to the power of minus 4 per second because it is a first order reaction. So the answer is yes, option B. 4 into 10 to the power of minus 4 per second. You should have an eye on the unit used also because unit is also important. Per second is the unit of, because there may be two options of having the same numerical value but different unit. You should be very careful about the unit also. The unit of rate constant in a first order reaction is per second. So the option B is correct. Question number 7, it's a tabular column data problem. Usually one such problem we expect in the exam. Three experiments are being done. The reaction is A plus B gives products. You read the problem. A plus B gives products. Data is given, experiment 1, experiment 2, experiment 3. The order of the reaction with respect to A and with respect to B, they have asked. Four options, 0, 2, 2, 1, 2, 0, 1, 2. These are the options. What you have to do in such problems is, select two experiments in which the concentration of B is constant first. Observe the tabular column. In two trials, the concentration of B will be constant. In our data, experiment 1, experiment 2. Here, concentration of B is constant, 0.2, 0.2. Yes, come to the first column. What have they done? Concentration of A is doubled, 0.2, 0.4. A is doubled, B is kept constant. Now observe the rate. 2.4 has become 9.6. Four times the rate has increased. Rate is doubled. The concentration is doubled. Rate has increased four times. Concentration is doubled. Rate has increased four times. What should be the power here? 2. So the order of the reaction with respect to A is 2. Power itself is the order. Now select two experiments where A concentration is same. In the trial 2 and 3, A concentration is kept constant. At the same time, B concentration has been doubled. Observe the rate. There is no change in the rate. Here also it is 9.6, here also it is 9.6. In spite of doubling the concentration of the reactant, there is no change in the rate of the reaction. So 2 should be equal to 1, means it, the power should be 0. The order of the reaction with respect to B is 0. With respect to A it is 2. With respect to B it is 0. The answers are 2, 0. Obviously, option C. Question number 8. The average rate becomes equal to instantaneous rate of a reaction when delta T equals 0, delta T approaches 0, delta T equals 1, delta T not equal to dt. This is a very easy question, definition based. Average rate becomes instantaneous rate when delta T approaches 0. It cannot become 0, it approaches 0. Naturally, option B is correct. It's a definition based question. Question number 9. This is the reaction given. N2 plus 3H2 gives 2NH3. Observe the equation properly. You have been given rate of formation of NH3 means dNH3 by dt. It is given as 4 into 10 to the power of minus 5 mole per dm cube per second. rate of formation is not rate. Let us, to find the rate, you have to divide the rate of formation by the stoichiometric coefficient. So rate equals, divide this by 2, you get 2 into 10 to the power of minus 5. This is not asked in the problem. They have asked rate of disappearance of hydrogen. This is asked. Rate of disappearance is obtained by multiplying the rate of the reaction with the respective stoichiometric coefficient. Equals 6 into 10 to the power of minus 5. So obviously option A is correct. Let me repeat. You have been given rate of formation of ammonia. Convert the rate of formation of ammonia to rate of the reaction by dividing it with stoichiometric coefficient 2. Yes, you get so much. To get the rate of disappearance of hydrogen, multiply the rate by the stoichiometric coefficient of hydrogen 3. This is the answer. Question number 10. The rate constant of a first order reaction, remember it is first order reaction, is 0.693 into 10 to the power of minus 2 per second. Rate constant is given. The time required for to reduce the concentration of the reactant to from 0.1 to 0.025 mole is 100 seconds, 200 seconds, 400 seconds, 25 seconds. Rate constant is given. The moment rate constant is given, you can find the half-life. For a first order reaction, half-life is 0.693 by K. 0.693 upon 0.693 into 10 to the power of minus 2 means 100 seconds. T half is 100 seconds. But you have not been asked to T half. 0.1 to 0.025. 0.1 becomes 0.05 in one half life. 0.05 becomes 0.025 in two half-lives. For 0.1 to become 0.025, we need two half-lives. So one half-life is 100 seconds, 2T half will be 200 seconds, and that is the answer. So 200 seconds means option B. Coming to problem number 11. In the gaseous state, A gaseous plus 2, A gaseous gives B gaseous plus half C gaseous. This is the equation given. The pressure of the reaction mixture increases from 80 millimeter to 100 millimeter in 5 minutes. The rate of disappearance of A has been asked. Rate of disappearance of A means dA by dt. What is its initial concentration? What is its final concentration? Divided by the time taken. Look, this is slightly difficult problem. To begin with, we had only A, no products. The total pressure to start with is being given as 80 millimeters. So A was 80 millimeter, B was 0, C was 0, because in the beginning we did not have any product. After 5 minutes, some of A has reacted, means the pressure of A should have come down. We don't know how much. We shall take it as 80 minus P after 5 minutes. After 5 minutes, 80 minus P. That means P millimeters of A has reacted. 1 A gives 1 B and half C. P millimeters of A should give you P millimeters of B and half P millimeters of C. So the total pressure after 5 minutes is 80 minus P plus P plus P by 2 means 80 plus P by 2. So initially it was 80. After 5 minutes it has become 80 plus P by 2. This has been given, 80 plus P by 2 has been given as 100 millimeters. So P by 2 equals 100 minus 80, 20 millimeters. P equals 40 millimeters. So out of 80 millimeters, 40 has reacted. So only 40 millimeter of A is remaining. So that is the concentration of A, 40. In how many minutes? 5 minutes, dA by dt. So the rate of the rate of disappearance of A is 8 millimeter per second. So amongst the option given, the option is D. Question number 12. The reaction given is AA plus BB gives products. Mostly this question would have been discussed in our class also. The rate law is given like this. R equals K into square bracket A to the power of alpha into B to the power of beta. This is called rate law. In the rate law expression, the powers of the molar concentrations of the reactants may or may not be equal to stoichiometric coefficients. Let me repeat. The powers of the molar concentrations of the reactants in the rate law expression may or may not be equal to the stoichiometric coefficients. Therefore, option 4 is correct. Option D is correct. What is that option? A plus B and alpha plus beta may or may not be equal. Question number 13. The rate law for a reaction is R equals K into square bracket A to the power of A into B to the power of B. This is called R1. If the concentration of A is doubled and B is halved, the rate becomes 2, R2. Then R2 by R1 will be, 4 options are given. Look here, in such problems, let us take square bracket A as X, square bracket B as Y. So R1 equals, follow this carefully, K into X to the power of A into Y to the power of B, or that is R1. The concentration of X is doubled. X becomes 2X now. 2X to the power of A, Y is halved. Y becomes Y by 2 to the power of B. This can be written as K into 2 to the power of A divided by 2 to the power of B will be 2 to the power of A minus B into X to the power of A into Y to the power of B. 2 to the power of A, 2 to the power of B in the denominator will be 2 to the power of A minus B. R2 by R1 equals K into 2 to the power of A minus B into X to the power of A, Y to the power of B, divided by R1 is K into X to the power of A into Y to the power of B. This cancels. So the answer is 2 to the power of A minus B. So option D is correct. That is question number 13. Question number 14. For a second order reaction, the unit of rate constant. Earlier I had given you the formula to find the unit of rate constant. It is mole per dm cube to the power of 1 minus n per second. Second order means put n equals 2, 1 minus 2 will be minus 1. Mole to the power of minus 1 means per mole. Dm to the power of minus 3 raised to the power of minus 1 is dm cube per second. So it is per mole dm cube per second. You go through all the four options. So option C is correct. Per mole dm cube per second. Question number 15. In a first order reaction, the concentration of the reactant decreases from 8 mole per dm cube to 0.5 mole per dm cube in 80 minutes. The rate constant of the reaction is, four options are there, 3.465 into 10 to the power of minus 2, 34.65 into 10 to the power of minus 2, 6.93 into 10 to the power of minus 2, 6.93 into 10 to the power of minus 3. So 8 becomes 0.5, 80 minutes, it is a first order reaction. Look, like this, 8 becomes 4 in one half life. 4 becomes 2 in 2 half lives. 2 becomes 1 in 3 half lives. 1 becomes 0.5 in 4 half lives. 8 to become 0.5, we need 4 half lives. 4 half lives is given as 80 minutes. So 1 half life should be 20 minutes. Once you find half life, rate constant is 0.693 by k by t half. So that should be 0.0693 by 2. It is 0.0346 or 3.46 into 10 to the power of minus 2 per second. So obviously option A is correct. Coming to question number 16, in a first order reaction A gives B, the ratio of the molar concentrations of A and B in the reaction mixture after the expiry of 100 minutes is 1:3. The time needed from the start to have the ratio of 1:1 will be slightly confusing problem. Look, this reaction is a first order reaction. The reaction has been conducted for 100 minutes. Then the ratio of A and B is 1:3. That means A is 1 out of 4. A is 1 out of 4 after 100 minutes. Andre, after 100 minutes, only 1/4 of A is remaining. Or 3/4 of A has reacted. Both mean the same. 1/4 of A is still there, implies 3/4 of A has reacted. 3/4 means 75% of the reactant has reacted. For 75% reaction, we need 2 half-lives. 2 half-lives is given as 100 minutes. So T half should be 50 minutes. The question is, what time or how much time is required to have the ratio 1:1? A is 1 out of 2. Means half A is remaining, means half of it has reacted. Half of it reacted means 1/2 life. 1/2 life is 50 minutes. So they go through the options. The option B is correct. Look here, let me repeat again. 1:3 means 1 A is left out of 4. Means 1/4 A is remaining. 3/4 of A has reacted. Means 75% reaction is over. For 75% we need 2 half-lives. 2 half-lives means 100 minutes. Half-life is 50 minutes. Ratio 1:1 means 1 A out of 2. half A is remaining, means 50% of the reaction is over. The time required is one half life, that is 50 minutes. Number 17, observe that it is a zero order reaction. The concentration of the reactant is reduced to 1/4. Suppose it is R naught, it becomes R naught by 4. In what time? 3 hours. So to start with, it was R naught. Now it is R naught by 4. The time taken for half of the reaction to complete would be 2 hours, 3 hours, 1.5 hours, 1 hour. Look, what is K of a zero order reaction given by? R naught minus R by T. R naught remains R naught only. R is R naught by 4. T is 3 hours. So that will be 3 R naught by 4 into 3. Or R naught by 4. You have been asked to find the time required for half of the reaction to complete. T half of a zero order reaction is given by R naught by 2k. R naught divided by 2 into k is here, R naught by 4. So that will be 2 hours. So option A is correct. Option A is correct. Question number 18, for a first order reaction, the ratio of T 7 by 8 to T half is, 4 options given, 7, 8, 3, 2. 7 by 8 andre, you convert it into percentage, then you will get a correct idea. It is 87.5%. 7 by 8 andru vande. 87.5% andru vande. Half andre 50%. You got to start with, we will have 100% of the reactant. 100 becomes 50 in one half life. 50 becomes 25 in two half lives. 25 becomes 12.5 in three half. ಅಂದರೆ 100 ಇದ್ದಿದ್ದು 12.5 ಆಗಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಅಂದರೆ 87.5% ಖರ್ಚಾಗಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ 3 ಹಾಫ್ ಲೈಫ್ಸ್ ಬೇಕು. ಸೊ 87.5% ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಸ್ 3 ಹಾಫ್ ಲೈಫ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಆಸ್ಕ್ಡ್ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ದ ರೇಷಿಯೋ ಆಫ್ ಟಿ 7/8 ಟು ಟಿ ಹಾಫ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್. It is 3 T half by T half under 3. So option C is correct. Coming to question number 19. For a reaction, R equals K into A into B. K into A into B. Initially, square bracket A was 1 mole per dm cube, B also was 1 mole per dm cube. Means initially R equals K. So the rate constant of the reaction is same as the initial rate of the reaction. And the rate was 4 into 10 to the power of minus 2. The K value is known. R is given. 4 into 10 to the power of minus 2. Square bracket A is 1 molar, B is also 1 molar. Therefore, K equals 4 into 10 to the power of minus 2. You have been asked to find the rate of the reaction when 90% of A and B have reacted. 90% of the reactants have reacted. So, out of 1 mole, 90% andre 0.9 is gone, has reacted. 0.9 is better, only 0.1 is remaining. 0.1b is remaining. So R equals K into 0.1 into 0.1. K is 4 into 10 to the power of minus 2 into 0.1 into 0.1. And then 4 into 10 to the power of minus 4. So The four options given, 4 into 10 to the power of minus 4 andre, option D is correct. Nodi, question number 20. Yes, the reaction is given is A gives products. Remember, it is a first order reaction. You have been given T 1 by 3 as 1 hour. Andre, 1/3 of the reaction is complete in 1 hour. What fraction of the initial concentration of A would react in the second hour from the start of the reaction? First hour, 1/3 of A has reacted. 2 hours, what fraction of A will react? ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಒನ್ ಅವರಲ್ಲಿ 1/3 ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆದರೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಅವರಲ್ಲೂ 1/3 ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗೋದು. ಒನ್ ಅವರಲ್ಲಿ 1/3 ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆದರೆ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಅವರ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂದರೆ 2 ಅವರ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ ಅವಾಗಲೂ 1/3 ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗೋದು. ಆದರೆ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಅವರಲ್ಲಿ 1/3 ಆಫ್ 1 ಈಸ್ 1/3. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಅವರ್ಲಿ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಅವರ್ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ಈಗ 1 ಇತ್ತು, ಅದ್ರಲ್ಲಿ 1/3 ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗೋಯ್ತು ಅಂದರೆ 1 ಉಳಿದಿಲ್ಲ, ಈಗ 2/3 ಉಳಿದಿದೆ. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ 1/3 ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಆಗತ್ತೆ ಅಂದರೆ 4/9. ಕರೆಕ್ಟಾಗಿ ಫಾಲೋ ಮಾಡಿ. ಮೊದಲು 1 ಇತ್ತು, 1 ಇದ್ದಾಗ 1/3 ಆಫ್ 1 ಅಂದರೆ 1/3 ಆಯಿತು. 1 ಅವರ್ ಆದಮೇಲೆ 1 ಇಲ್ಲ, 2/3 ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ 1/3 ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟೆಡ್. 1/3 ಆಫ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೆಫ್ಟ್ ಅಂದರೆ 1/3 ಆಫ್ 2/3 ಅಂದರೆ 4/9 ವಿಲ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಅವರ್. ಸೊ ದಿ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಆರ್ 2/9, 1/9, 7/9, 4/9. ಸೊ ವಿಚ್ ದ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್? ಸೊ 4/9 ದಿ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಅವರ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್. ಎಷ್ಟಾಗುತ್ತೆ? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 4/9. ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಎ ಇಸ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್. So, next is 21. Question number 21. 2NO plus O2 gives 2NO2. 2NO plus O2 gives 2NO2. When the volume of the reaction vessel is doubled, ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಡಬಲ್ಡ್ ಅಂದರೆ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಡಬಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಗೆಸ್ ಹಾವ್ಡ್, ಮೊದಲೆಷ್ಟಿತ್ತು ಅದರ ಅರ್ಧ ಆಗತ್ತೆ. ವೆನ್ ದಿ ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ವೆಸಲ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಬಲ್ಡ್, ಕಾನ್ಸಂಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಹಾವ್ಡ್. ದಿ ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ 2+1 ಅಂದರೆ 3. ಸೊ ದಿ ರೇಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ಹಾಫ್ ಕ್ಯೂಬ್. ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಆಲ್ವೇಸ್ ಕಮ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಪವರ್ ಅಂದರೆ 1/8. ಅಂದರೆ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಷನ್ ರೇಟ್ 1 ಇದ್ದರೆ ಅದು 1/8 ಆಗಿಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ, 8 ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗಿಬಿಡುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ದಿ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಗಿವನ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಬೈ 8 ಟೈಮ್ಸ್, ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಬೈ 8 ಟೈಮ್ಸ್, ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಬೈ 4 ಟೈಮ್ಸ್, ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ 1/4 ಆಫ್ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಒರಿಜಿನಲ್ ರೇಟ್. ಸೊ ದಿ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿಕ್ರೀಸಸ್ ಬೈ 8 ಟೈಮ್ಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ಬಿ. 22nd, for a first order reaction, the reaction is complete to the extent of 20% and 92% in 10 minutes and 110 minutes respectively. Specific reaction rate andru vande, rate constant andru vande, K equals question mark. Erdu time interval nalli reaction kottaga, earlier I had given you the formula K equals 2.303 by T2 minus T1 into log of R1 by R2. Idu formula. 2.303 by T2 minus T1, 110 minus 100 aayitu. Log of R1, 20% reaction agide, ulidirudu 80. Eshtu ulidide ennodu R1. 92% reaction agide andre 8% ulidide. 8 tens are log 10 is 1. So it is 2.303 into 10 to the power of minus 2 per second. So the option yes, A, B, C. Option C is correct. Question number 23. For a reaction, some data is given. Time is first two. Time in hours, 0, 20, 30. Pressure, 0.6, 0.4, 0.3. Gaseous reactant in atmosphere. The order of the reaction is 0, 1, 2, unpredictable. We feel that this is a very difficult problem. We shall find the rate of the reaction. Let us find the rate in this time interval. 0.6 becomes 0.4 in 20 hours. And then what will be the rate of the reaction? 0.6 minus 0.4 divided by 20. And then 0.2 divided by 20. And then 2 into 10 to the power of minus 1 divided by 10. 20 and 10 to the power of minus 2 aayga ee interval al kandidena aayga yes this minus this 0.1 time interval is 10 equals 10 to the power of minus 2 so the rate of the reaction in this interval is 10 to the power of minus 2 in this interval also it is 10 to the power of minus 2 the rate of the reaction is constant at different time intervals That is possible only in a zero order reaction. So the order of the reaction should be zero. Option A is correct. The rate of the reaction goes on decreasing as the reaction advances. Time aagta, rate kadame agate. Suppose the rate is constant in any problem, it means it is a zero order reaction. Option A is correct. Problem number 24. Which of the following reaction is first order? Idanna organic chemistry nalli first chapter nalli SN1 SN2 reaction study maadi gottirutte nimge SN1 reaction means first order reaction SN1 reaction andre tertiary butyl bromide nodi yavudalli ide tertiary butyl bromide anta option C nalli ide idu nimge gottirutte so SN2 reaction andre alkyl primary alkyl halide tagobeku a SN1 andre tertiary alkyl halide tagobeku option C now kelirudu first order reaction adrinda option C coming to question number 25 if the activation energy of the forward reaction is 150 and that of the reverse reaction is 260 what is the enthalpy change of the reaction forward reaction ge 160 backward reaction ge forward reaction ge 150 backward reaction ge 260 look forward reaction is activation energy kotiyare forward reaction ge 150 kilojoules backward reaction ge 260 kilojoules what is the enthalpy very simple formula enthalpy of a reaction is ea forward reaction minus ea backward reaction 150 minus 260 is minus 110. So option B is correct. The formula gap kaitkoli. Delta H equals EA of the forward reaction minus EA of the backward reaction. Coming to 26. What is the time required for a first order reaction to be 99% complete compared to the time taken to be 90% complete? No change, time taken is double, triple, time required is half. Nodi, 90% complete and what is the time required for the reaction, first order reaction to be 99% complete? If it is 90% complete, what is the time interval? Nodi, 99%ಗೆ 1 hour ಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. 90% ಅಂದರೆ 90%ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಟೈಮ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಿ 90% ಟು ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್. 99%ಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೋ ಟೈಮು. ಈಗ ಟಿ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ಸ್, ಇದು 99% ಕ್ಯಾಲ್ಕುಲೇಟ್ ಮಾಡ್ತೀನಿ ನಾನೀಗ, 2.303/k ಲಾಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ 100 ಅಂತ ತಗೋಬೇಕು. 99% ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟೆಡ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಉಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಒಂದೇನೆ. ಲಾಗ್ 100 ಅಂದರೆ 2 equals 2.303 into 2/k, ಅದು 99%. 90%ಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ದಾರೆ. 90% ಅಂದರೆ 2.303/k ಲಾಗ್ ಆಫ್ 100. 90% ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಅಂದರೆ 10 ಮಾತ್ರ ಉಳ್ಕೊಳ್ಳುತ್ತೆ. ಲಾಗ್ 10 ಇಸ್ 1, 2.303/k. ಟಿ 90% ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಬೈ ಟಿ 99% equals this over this. Obviously it will be 2. Therefore T 90% ನಿಮಗೆ ಕೇಳಿರೋದು ಕಂಪೇರ್, ಎಸ್ T 90% T 99% by 90% equals to T 90% equals half of T 99. So the time required is time half of the initial value. Option D is correct. Question number 27. The activation energy of a reaction is zero. The rate constant of the reaction increases with temperature, decreases with temperature, decreases with the decrease of temperature, nearly independent of temperature. This is a direct problem. Arrhenius equation bariri. K equals AE to the power of minus EA by RT. Activation energy is zero on rate. The entire numerator becomes 0. A into e to the power of 0. E to the power of 0 is 1. K becomes constant. The temperature term will disappear. So the rate constant of the reaction remains almost independent of temperature. Option D is correct. Question number 28. The activation energy of a reaction is found to be 2.303 RT anta kotidare. The ratio of the rate constant to Arrhenius factor andre K by A kandidibeku. K equals A into E to the power of minus EA by RT. So EA is given, K equals A into E to the power of minus 2.303 RT by RT, andre K by A equals E to the power of minus 2.303. Yerat kade no ln tagolna. Ln of K by A equals minus 2.303 into ln of E is 1. Ega ln na log maadna. Log maadbekare 2.303 inda multiply maadidre log agutte. Equals minus 2.303, cancel ಮಾಡ್ಬೋದು. Log of K by A equals 1, minus 1. So K by A equals 10 to the power of minus 1. Option is A.